If you've noticed the help wanted signs in every second shop window, you already know we are staring down the barrel of an urgent nationwide skills crisis.
Bad news, Australia, we're fresh out of workers.
For the first time in our history, we have more job vacancies out there than we actually do registered unemployed people.
And unlike the supremely silky Shea Bolton, we're critically short on skills, specifically these ones.
Construction managers, civil engineering professionals, early childhood teachers, registered nurses, ICT business, software and applications programmers, electricians, chefs, childcare, aged and disability carers.
That's largely due to the huge pandemic-shaped dent in our migration numbers. So business types want to see our permanent visa intake soar from 160,000 to 200,000 a year for the next 2 years.
We need to open the pipeline up. We want to see some flexibility in the market.
As long as it doesn't kill wage growth for Aussie workers, the ACTU's on board. But our COVID response didn't just slow the flow of new migrant workers, it forced out plenty of the skilled ones we did have.
There was no support for employers to provide to temporary visa holders in JobKeeper or JobSeeker. So not only have we had thousands upon thousands of people leave, some of them have had a bad experience and they're not all going to automatically return.
And we've still got a backlog of nearly 60,000 applications to get through.
And that's why my ministerial colleagues are working very hard, firstly, to unclog the visa application process.
Also,
migration is part of the solution.
It's not the only part of the solution.
Migration is one issue, but it's not the only issue.
It's part of the solution.
But it's not the only part.
Great minds, eh? So what's the rest of the solution look like?
A real long-term plan and commitment to address the labour shortage. And that really means a real partnership with education and training.
That means increasing participation, especially among women, and getting as serious about skills as this bloke.
Bolton, wow. With a ripper.
That is part of why we're calling the Jobs and Skills Summit.
Well, the problem we're going to have here is that we're in competition with every other country in the world for workers. And so when this job summit goes on next week on Thursday, Friday, they're going to have a big argument. The unions are going to say, well, OK, we can up the immigration level if you like, but that's going to kill wage growth and they won't stand for that. So this
what
is
do you think the solution is?
It's got to be central to... Well, it's a mixture of all of it. I mean, do have to let a lot of migrants back in. Skilled workforce would be the best way to go.
They've got to want to come. That's
the true.
Problem.
And do you want to go to Canada or do you want to go to New Zealand? Where do you want to go? You want to go to the United States?
I mean, yeah. And if you've got it, we've had a closed border for a long time, and I think most of the country was very supportive of that. But that
has to be the short-term solution, doesn't it? There's no point saying, oh, we're going to do better at skills training. Well, that's going to take years.
You look at some of the industries, though, that are struggling the most, childcare, aged care, early learning, nurses. These are the people that went through hell the last few years. How many of them have just gone, I'm out and I'm not coming back, you know?
That's exactly
and a lot of them left aged care and went into less demanding jobs for more money.
Mm. Mm.